The last cereal video we did was Lucky Charms.
Right.
You learned that each of the marshmallows had a superpower.
Yeah.
Which is really cool.
Absolutely.
Lucky is one of the most powerful beings in the universe.
Yes.
So you can go check that video out if you're in the mood for Lucky Charms. But if you're in the mood for a different cereal, say Fruity Pebbles or Cocoa Pebbles.
Okay.
Stay parked where you're at.
I'm parked.
I'm going to tell you a little background about these cereals. So Fruity Pebbles and Cocoa Pebbles were actually reintroductions of an unpopular cereal made by Post Cereal that was released in 1959 called Sugar-Coated Rice Crinkles.
I wonder why it was unpopular.
Sugar-Coated Rice Crinkles had a mascot that was a clown that seriously looks like it's straight out of the movie It, and you're gonna see why. Take a look.
Breakfast! I'm hungry! Take it from Crinkles, that's me. The best breakfast under the big top is Post Sugar Rice Crinkles. Honey and sugar make it different and wonderful. A circus of fun to eat. So you crinkle on down to the store for Post Sugar Rice Crinkles, the greatest cereal treat on earth.
It's very scary. It's very creepy looking. And I told you, it looks like it's out of It.
It
looks like it's ripped
legitimately
out.
Legitimately It. Trying to feed me Rice Crinkles.
And if you don't believe it, this was actually their second mascot. The first mascot was a little Chinese boy named So High, because he was, quote, so high off the ground.
Post Rice Crinkles.
What'd you say?
So High said, rice that is crinkled is sweetest to eat because it's crinkled with sugar, and sugar is sweet. Now, what you say?
Same as you. Crinkles are crinkly and sweetest to eat.
So High, this little Chinese boy that was the mascot, he actually wore a bowl of Rice Crinkles on his head.
Oh, you know, nothing like putting rice on Asian boys' heads and calling it advertising.
Yes, they went from a Chinese boy to a clown, and the cereal still wasn't successful, so surprise, surprise.
Where do they turn to?
They turned to the product manager, Larry Wise, who purchased a license from Hanna-Barbera because he wanted to use the Flintstones in hopes that he could stick the characters on Sugar Rice Crinkles and give it a new life. So this was actually the very first time that a product was branded around a character, and that the character wasn't just borrowed for some promotional thing, but that the cereal was actually going to be centered around the Flintstones. So people at first were afraid that it was just going to be a passing fad, that it would be done by the end of the year, it wouldn't be successful at all. But despite those reservations, the cereal was reintroduced in 1969, and its success on the West Coast led to a national demand. And it has ever since been one of the most consistently best-selling cereals of all time.
Are you serious?
Yep. Ever since it was reintroduced in 1969. The marketing for the Pebbles cereals started off really cute in the beginning. So it'd be like Fred and Barney, and they're having cereal at breakfast with Wilma and Betty, or they're sharing their cereal with some human kids. And then the commercials started to turn into Barney stealing Fred's cereal, to which Fred would shout,
Barney, my Pebbles!
Yes, that's what I remember.
You remember that?
Yes.
That was like,
Barney, my Pebbles!
That was the shtick.
Yeah.
That ongoing joke. And like for years, it would do this. For years, Barney would always be trying to steal Fred's Pebbles. And he would like sneak, he would pretend to be different characters, he'd pretend to be Santa Claus, just to steal Fred's Pebbles.
Did Barney ever dress up like Lucky?
He did not.
Should have.
I really don't know if that, you know, that would have gone well.
What is with all these cereal characters always being chased or chasing after the person with their cereal?
That is exactly what I wanted to look into. There was one commercial that aired in 2010 that actually got Post Cereal sued.
No way.
By Hulk Hogan.
In 2010?
2010, Post Cereal was sued by Hulk Hogan because in the commercial, Barney and Fred are in this wrestling ring against a big wrestler named Hulk Boulder. And after Hulk Boulder beats up Barney and Fred, Bam Bam comes to the rescue and literally cracks Hulk Boulder into a bunch of tiny pieces.
Wins, but not for long. Bam, 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 bam. Wow, nothing beats smacking down the big chocolatey taste of all those little pebble pieces.
Chocolatey.
Speaking of little pieces,
to be fair, it does actually kind of look like Hulk Hogan.
A little bit.
It's big, it's blonde, it looks like Hulk Hogan, and apparently Hulk Hogan actually did use the name Hulk Boulder very early in his career.
Oh, please.
He said the commercial damaged his image.
It's 2010. His image was plenty damaged enough already.
And the lawsuit was settled the same year, but under the condition that the commercial would never be aired again. So now it's on YouTube for everyone to see for all eternity.
Streisand effect at its finest.
Yep. But there is one wrestler who loves Fruity Pebbles. In fact, he officially endorses them.
And his name is John Cena!
No, not John Cena!
John Cena. John officially Cena? Endorses Fruity Pebbles.
No way.
So the story behind this is that Dwayne The Rock Johnson gave John Cena the nickname A Bowl of Fruity Pebbles because John Cena wore all these brightly colored shirts.
Come out here with your bright-ass purple shirt. And before that, your bright green shirt. Before that, your bright orange shirt. You run around here looking like a big fat bowl of Fruity Pebbles.
And now John Cena is actually in Fruity Pebbles commercials.
No way!
He's on a box with Bam Bam.
No.
He's in that universe now.
That's amazing.
I know.
That is absolutely amazing.
And there have been a lot of limited edition Pebbles.
Really?
Like, I had no idea. Bedrock Blizzard, Dino S'mores Pebbles, Cupcake Pebbles, Sugar Cookie Pebbles, Candy Corn Pebbles, Ice Berry Pebbles, Cinnamon Pebbles.
I want Ice Berry Pebbles.
That's like the tip of the iceberg.
You know what I think is really cool about Fruity Pebbles, chocolate pebbles, cocoa pebbles, is that the Flintstones live on. Because
yep,
they're not going to be making that cartoon. They're not making Flintstones movies. Flintstones is effectively like a dead IP.
Yeah.
It's not going to get revived because we had that wonderful live action movie with Rosie O'Donnell in the 90s.
Right. I mean, that's it.
You can't reboot something that terrible.
Fruity Pebbles and Cocoa Pebbles is actually like carrying on the Flintstones' life legacy, which is really cool.
Because they were the first primetime cartoon that was more for adults. They are the original OG Simpsons.
Yep.
Like, you know, that is the Flintstones. And I think it's super cool that they get to live on through this serial that apparently still kicks butt.
Yep.
And is being bought by, you know, kids and adults everywhere.
I know.
And
since 1969, one of the best-selling cereals of all time, consistently.
I've never had it before, but I'm going to make it, like,
now you're
top
priority. You want to try it now.
I want to try these Pebbles. I'm so happy. Like, this made me so happy to know that this is a thing.
Yeah,
and, like, the Flintstones live on.
Okay, that is wrapped now, our segment.
Excellent.
Fruity Pebbles and Cocoa Pebbles. I hope you enjoyed it.
I did.
Until next time. Bye!
Bye!